Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Well, today I'm going to show you how to fold this heart ring. This is a model that I designed recently, and this particular one is folded out of a fourth of this very fancy foil paper. I don't remember where I got this, but it didn't really work very well anyway because it was too thick. I'd recommend using foil paper, but in case you don't have foil, I'm going to try to fold it out of a sheet of ordinary kami. And this is from a 3-inch square, so I'm going to show you how to divide this into fourths to get a 3-inch square. So start out, right side up, valley fold in half, and crease really sharply. Give it about 5 good creases, and unfold, and rotate, and fold in half in this direction. And once again, crease really sharply with your fingernail. Okay, and now unfold, turn over, and now what you're going to do is make a tiny tear right at the top, right where the crease is. So just hold it like this and just carefully pull your fingers apart. Try to make the tear go right onto the crease. And now what you want to do is push the paper together so that this makes a ridge, and make the ridge go from small to tall. Like that, okay, and hold it like this. And now very carefully separate your hands. Just pull them apart and try to make it very even, like this. And if it's a rough edge like that, if it's too rough, that means that you didn't make that crease sharp enough. So go back and do that again. Okay, and now we're going to divide each of these, but actually we only really need to divide this one, unless you want to make 4 heart rings. Okay, this is the rough edge. I'm going to go to this side and make the little tear on the clean side here. And then make the ridge and separate it like that. Okay, and here we have a 3-inch square. So let's turn over and fold diagonally in half. Crease sharply and unfold and rotate, and let's fold diagonally in half in this direction. Okay, and unfold, and now fold the corner to the middle. And unfold and rotate, and fold this corner to the middle. And unfold, and now fold this corner to this intersection, the last crease. And unfold, and now fold it to the first crease, the nearest crease, right to the intersection point. Okay, and rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this corner to this point. So corner to corner, and unfold, and fold it to the nearest intersection point. Like that, okay? And now let's turn over, and let's fold this edge right to the middle crease, but actually let's leave about a millimeter, so millimeter short of the middle crease. So that's like that. I'm gonna show you up close. See? Okay. I'm gonna zoom in. Okay, now let's rotate and let's fold this edge right here to this crease, but once again, let's go a millimeter short. So how far should the 2 triangles be apart? 2 millimeters. Okay, let's unfold this flap and let's fold this edge to this crease. And when you fold it, make sure that this doesn't slide. You still want to see that red stripe. So fold it right to the crease. Okay, and now let's fold this edge up on this crease. And once again, hold it so that it doesn't slip. It's gonna slip a little bit, but if it can slip the least possible, that's best. Okay, and try to make it even all the way across. Like that. And crease sharply. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And make sure it goes to the edge all the way across. And now it should be lining up right with the crease. Like that. And like that. Okay, now let's fold this flap down like this and rotate. And let's fold this flap up, well, unfold it. Okay, and we're gonna do the same thing on this side. So let's first fold this edge to this crease. And once again, try to hold it down so that it doesn't slide. Okay, and let's fold on this crease. Okay, crease it sharply. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. Hopefully this should come to a square here and here. Might have to just sort of adjust it a little bit. Good enough. Okay. And crease sharply. And let's fold this flap down. Okay, now these are overlapping a little bit. And what I'm gonna do is just lift it up so that they're pressed up against each other. They're touching but not overlapping. And in that position, I'm gonna just flatten it so that it forces it to line up. You see, now it's just perfectly a square. Okay. So here we have the ring and the square for a square ring. Just bring the flaps together and tie them in. But we're gonna make the heart. So let's unfold here and let's fold this corner to this point, the intersection of this edge and the crease. And now let's fold the flap up. All right, now let's fold this flap behind. And we're gonna fold it behind so that the white disappears. So the band comes together like this, and the white part right here disappears. Okay. And let's turn over. And now we're going to fold this flap, I don't know, the band, this strip. We're gonna fold it back up and fold it a little bit above this crease right here. You can adjust this later depending on the size of your finger. Okay, and so there we have a pleat. And let's do the same pleat on this part right here. So let's turn over And let's fold it behind, making sure that the white disappears. And you also can just match it. Just try to make it so this length should be the same as this length. And now turn over and let's fold this flap back like this and just match it. Try to make it symmetrical. Okay. And now we're going to turn over and mountain fold this whole thing behind, but don't actually flatten it. Just make it about 90 degrees. So this part right here is a 90 degree angle. And that's because if you really try to flatten it, it might tear right here. So I wouldn't recommend it. Okay, so this is all you really need to do. And now let's try to make the crevice in the heart. And the way to make the crevice is that we have to push this point in very carefully. And just give it a try with your fingernail. Just try to push it in like this. And you're gonna notice that you're trying to make two diagonal folds. So, yeah, that's pretty good. But if you really wanna do a good diagonal fold, you'll make them separate. So like I'm gonna try to make this left diagonal fold. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fold the right part over the edge, and now I'm just gonna focus on the diagonal edge. I'm gonna unfold these for now. Okay, so fold this over, and then just fold the diagonal edge there, okay? And make that really sharp so it'll stay in the paper. Unfold, and now let's fold the left side behind and squash to make the right diagonal. And now you really have a lot of control to make the right diagonal. And now you can make them both together, and you see it's just a lot sharper and a lot cleaner. Well, a little bit cleaner anyway. I don't know. I experiment with that. Okay, so there you have the crevice in the heart, and I'm going to bring these pleats back and make sure that it's symmetrical looking. And now let's turn over, and to complete the band, you could stick one inside the other, and voila. That might not stay very well. I don't know. I didn't even give it a chance. Okay, but this is the way that it really will stay well. What you do is you stick the corners together, and I'm gonna turn over and fold the two corners up just like this. Okay, and flatten it. And now open these two flaps right here. So just open like that, keeping the two corners together. So one hand can keep the two corners together while the other hand unfolds these. Okay, and now fold this edge to these points right here. So just fold it over like that. And then close this flap and close this flap. And we are all locked. So just open the ring and flatten like this. And now just round it out. Shape it, sculpt it so that it looks like a nice round ring. Forget looks like, it is a nice round ring. And if you're, you know, try it on your finger. If there's a lot of space on your finger, then you might want to make it smaller, and you just adjust this fold by going like this and like this. So now it'll stick on my pinky finger. yeah, and there it is. And if you want, you can just try to fold the very tippy edge behind to make it look a little bit nicer, because I don't know, the raw edge isn't quite as nice as the folded edge. especially since we tore the paper instead of cut it. And so yeah, there it is. And you can, I don't know, try to sculpt it to make it a little bit more round. And my crevice got messed up, but the crease is still in the paper, so it shouldn't be too hard to bring it back. Is the heart ring out of Kami, and I injured myself doing construction. Maybe I'll put it there. Oh, look, now it's all better. All right, well, hope you guys were able to fold that. It's challenging doing out of Kami. Once again, I'd recommend using foil. It's just a little bit easier. And so yeah, happy Valentine's Day, and hope this serves you well in your romantic endeavors. All right, bye-bye.